Hello everyone, Kay Kim here. Today is November 17th, 2017, Friday. Welcome to the market update. Again, my name is Kay Kim with the Traders Club. As I record this video, market should be open another 3 hours or so, so you should be seeing some flashing lights on your left of your screen. Just a quick follow-up on Spider since the midweek update that I published on Wednesday. We talked about this channel pivot. Today we're going to be talking about actually Spider, IWM, XLF, Apple, Tesla, Intel, and we'll call it a day. So anyway, this rising pivot, the channel pivot, right? Channel resistance. We've been talking about that. We've been talking about this actually pretty much since October it broken out. We talked about how we want to watch that level. As long as we hold above that level, as long as we see that level holding, benefit of the doubt goes to buyers in the minor term. We also talked about that, you know, I see that, I forecast that it's going to come and hit this time several times possibly before going to my next target, which is 165. And so we hit it twice here and here, and we did see a you know, pretty sound gap up yesterday. And what that did was, with that gap up, what that did was that gap up actually filled, there was a little bit of gap here that filled that gap, there was that gap that also got filled that gap. I think this gap, safe to say, has been filled out also, so let me get rid of that. So all the gaps been filled, so that's a good sign, at least in the minor term. So so after the all the gap has been filled, we saw a little bit of slightly gap down today. This morning we're seeing a little bit of doji just kind of hanging around here a little bit. I also modified my moving averages. If you're following my moving averages, my 20MA is now setting at low to accommodate that recent pullback. So now my 20MA is setting at low, my 50MA is setting at close. This was low and now it's put it back to close, and my 100 SMA is setting at high. So if you are following my moving averages, those are my current setting. I just modified it just now, or yesterday, or a couple days, or yesterday when we saw that kind of move. So I wanted to kind of modify a little bit so that 20MA is supporting that recent move, because if it supported this move, it's likely as it starts to go up here that it could kind of support it in that vicinity. So as long as it holds above really 20MA and 50MA, you know, I have to say, give benefit of doubt goes to miners, benefit of the doubt goes to buyers in the minor term, and you know, and intermediate term. You know, as long as we stay above 100 SMA, obviously intermediate term. So those are three moving averages to watch. Should the price see a steep decline, maybe, I'm not sure when, we may not this year, as long as we hold above this rising channel. So let's see how that plays out. One thing I do want to report to you guys today is, let me actually get rid of some of the moving averages. What I wanted to report to you guys today is Spider. We do have bearish divergence to keep in mind. And it's not like really strong one. It's kind of pretty grindy, you know, but it's there. This does not mean like, oh my God, the correction is gonna come. Oh my God, like we're gonna see 5% correction. That's not what it means. What it means is, I think because of we have bearish divergence on Spider, we're probably not gonna see a whole lot of strength to the upside. We may see a grindy move, grinding higher move. We may even see some volatility continuing. We may even see some weakness kind of holding up. Remember I talked about, you know, we're probably gonna do something like that several times, hitting that channel. And so because of this, what this telling us is that we are seeing that the, you know, the trend is extended, and we are seeing some short-term distribution and some fear throughout that in the minor term, that they are not too confident that the market is going to go higher. And with that, We are seeing some distribution here, and we are seeing some volatility. And with this, bearish divergence on the daily chart, we're probably gonna see not gonna see a whole lot of move, and we're probably gonna have to wait until this gets nullified or reset. For it to get nullified, you want to see these divergences kind of move sideways a little bit and then get back up like this, you know, or sometimes they come all the way down and then reset. And at this point, I don't know how that's going to play out. Are we going to see a reset before getting back up, or are we going to see kind of a, you know, sideways move and then getting back up, nullifying this daily bearish divergence? So again, even with that, I don't believe we're not going to come all the way down. I believe that worst case scenario, it goes up and then we pull back again and maybe fill this gap, retest at 20 and retest that rising channel. Worst case scenario, come back and retest the 50 MA, because, you know, it needs to get below the channel, fake everybody out before getting back up. So I still, even with the bearish divergence in the picture, I still want to give benefit of the doubt to the buyers, because you're going to see, even with the volatile, even with the, you know, minor term volatility, you're going to see how buyers are going to fight. I mean, even with this gap down move, how many times that dip buyers came in, brought the price up on a daily basis, you know what I mean? And yesterday we saw a big gap up and follow through. So I still want to give benefit of doubt to the buyers, but at the same time, I want to make a note that there's daily bearish divergence in the picture. So I don't believe that this thing is ready for this. And seasonality wise, I think, you know, end of November and early December is always kind of a hectic weeks. Not that I've done a back testing, just in my personal experience trading, you know, last 10 years or so. And so I think there still could be some volatility coming in November, and we may see some up and down, gap up, gap down, intraday volatility, or maybe some grindy move, something like that. So let's see how that plays out here. Let's see. I'll continue to kind of monitor that daily bearish divergence, and then follow up with you guys next week, see how that's playing out. Russell 2000, we don't have bearish divergence on the Russell 2000 because we saw pretty swift, healthy correction. I mean, this was in October, now is, you know, middle of November. This is about a month and a half. It took its time. We're at about 3.5% correction. And so we don't have bearish divergence. We actually have much more healthy looking chart on the Russell 2000 ETF, at least looking at minor to intermediate term. So so strong bounce here and a prior resistance, new support. We also talked about this rising channel resistance level. Also, we talked about this gap area that got filled. Also, in the vicinity, we have the 50 MA, we got the 100 SMA we also talked about, and also talked about this as a first level of a Fibonacci, as you can see right there. So if there was a vicinity, we found support, we're continuing. We have actually all the indices, we're actually seeing Russell 2000 pretty much leading entire market, because you can see the, you know, transports down 1%, NASDAQ is down 0.19% today, semis down 1.33%, Dow is down 0.37%, Spider is down 0.17% so far, but Russell is up, is 0.64%. It's because Russell 2000 had that healthy correctional move last month and a half, while the other indices, they were just kind of grinding and grinding higher. So I think because of that, I think Russell 2000 could, lead the, I really think that Russell 2000 is going to continue to lead the market remainder this year, and maybe early part of next year. This is why I have heavily positioned on the Russell 2000 compared to my other. So Russell 2000, obviously, we're staying above the 20 now, and the 50 and the 100. We are getting above this downtrend resistance, going for the new high here. We got some nice looking follow through. We had that Morningstar reversal yesterday confirmed. That was a doji, you know, that was gap up. So this was a very, very strong reversal there, as you can see right there. So definitely that, yes, is a big confident looking gap up. That pretty much you know, in just 2 days, in just 1 day, we pretty much got about 6 days of downside move. In 1 day, we pretty much got all above all of that. So that was definitely a very, very good, you know, at least in a minor term, confirmation move. And then, you know, when it did gap down, this was a prior resistance, new support. We found some dip buyers there. And then you can see, we see that move here. So let's see how that plays out. I think, you know, should the price decline, we want to see the 20 MA starts to hold. And that's what we want to see. Also, just kind of following up with you guys on this 65 minute chart bullish divergence on IWM. We talked about this on my midweek update video on Wednesday. What you wanted to see, bullish divergence. You can see lower lows here. What you wanted to see is the price getting above the 50, right? This falling 50, this has been downtrend. You know, you can see that we've been cultivating lower highs. Finally, the price got above it, and then 50 MA is rising. Right, see that, right? You see that 50 MA rising. So should the price decline, we want to watch that 65 minute chart, you know, 50 MA acting as support. And then as this thing continues to rise, we have to continue to give benefit of doubt to the buyers in the minor term. Same thing happened. What happened back in 2017, lower low, higher low, right? Bullish divergence, 50 MA is acting in resistance, flip back, acting as support, and this thing rocketed, right? So as long as we stay above some of these moving averages I talked about, I want to continue to give benefit of doubt to the buyers. I think, you know, my next target, you know, 156, 160-ish. So let's see how that plays out. Quickly, let's look at XLF Banks. It's holding up here above the 50, just kind of hanging out here a little bit. Obviously, we're in an uptrend, higher lows and higher highs. You know, we got kind of a consolidation type of going here. I think some people might call this head and shoulder pattern. Definitely not a pattern to freak out. We had something similar maybe last time here, left shoulder, head, right shoulder, but we had a 1 day decline before reversing back up. So definitely, just because we have certain formation doesn't mean it's gonna kill everything. But worst case scenario, possibly fill this gap before going higher, or we come back down, retest a gap before going higher. It's tough to say, but I still want to give benefit of the doubt to the buyers. Quickly on Apple, you know, I mentioned on Apple that we had an island reversal, kind of looks similar to 2012 September. Well, with that gap, with that filled, that gap has been filled. So at least that, you know, at least that island reversal has been nullified. So that's a good sign. And so we're still above 10 or 20 and 50, 100. So I would still give benefit of doubt to the buyers. We are extended on the monthly. On the monthly chart, we have a doji. Again, November, you know, it's just still a bit, we still got a couple weeks to trade, but we're doji. We're still kind of in that level there. That I'm not saying that. I mean, this is not a level I want to start calling a top here, but definitely something to notice. And you can see that stochastic is kind of getting into that extended level. So I'm gonna just keep an eye on it. But we need more evidence before we can call it that. You know, the whole thing is gonna dismantled, right? If I see anything like that, I'll, you know, maybe write an article, give you guys an update. But for now, I still want to give benefit of doubt to the buyers on Apple. But I do want to not acknowledge that we are in an extended session looking at a big picture. Let's look at Tesla. Tesla has actually interesting construction here. What we have going on is we got this kind of a gigantic double top type of pattern, maybe like a left shoulder and right shoulder, like this is like ugly head and shoulder formation. At the same time, we got this pretty vivid, distinctive neckline. As you can see, this neckline here, you can see resistance, support, a pivot, kind of this is strong level. And so we gapped up to that level today, you can see right there, and then just kind of falling over here. So that's definitely, and fill this gap also, and we got that neckline here of that potentially ugly head and shoulder double top reversal pattern. So if we get rejected here, continue lower, then possibly some of the levels gonna provide a strong support here, 276, 261, and those are level to watch. Or Intel, I'll let you guys go with this. Intel obviously is pulling back. Just, you know, quickly going into my article here, I talked about back in, was it November 6th, talked about running into resistance. I just want to talk about a little bit. So this is obviously a chart here. That was the rising resistance. And you can see that weekly, my oscillators are, again, at this point, it doesn't mean that this thing is gonna do that. That's kind of what I talked about in my article. So you gotta be really under, you gotta understand that just because we have this signal, I don't believe that we're gonna see something like that. What I think we're gonna see a kind of a pullback, maybe retest some of these levels before going higher. So if you haven't read that, you can find this article on my twotradersclub.com. And looking at a big picture, obviously 17-year consolidation broke out of it. That's why the sentiment is different today. So we're gonna pull back a little bit, and before going, I don't believe, this is why we're not seeing, you know, like fast decline. We're seeing kind of slow distribution, because I think a lot of investors are still holding their shares and they're probably looking into add more. For me, I am all out of my calls, as you can see how I've been playing, and I've been writing article on this and following up. And this is where I bought calls and bought shares here, 3505, 3621. I got pretty sizable shares on this, and I'm holding full as of today. But all my calls are gone, as you can see there how I played it. But right now what I'm looking at is, if this thing come possibly challenge this gap somewhere in that vicinity, I'm thinking about possibly adding more shares, maybe getting back in with the calls. But what I wouldn't know at that point is that, well, is it gonna come here and fill, challenge this gap and then move higher? Or are we gonna fill this gap? That's something I don't know. And also we talked about how this Fibonacci, right? I measured this move to that move, got up, pull back, and we went to hit exactly at 161.8% and pulling back. So, what I like about that is Intel is starting to respect some of these technical levels. You know what I mean? Just like, you know, it's pulling back right at that, you know, that extended level that I showed you just now in my article. And that means that, what it means is that Intel is starting to really respect these technical levels. That means we're starting to get into a trend, right? Trend. I remember Intel hasn't been a trend for 18 years, looking at a big picture perspective. Intel has been, I like went too far. Intel has been in this, here, let's go to monthly. In this consolidation, this is not a trend. This is consolidation, right? Right, this 18-year consolidation. And now we're finally breaking out of that, and we're starting to get into a trend. And when that happens, that's when I believe that these technical levels are gonna start to really come in handy. Certain levels, like certain level support, certain level pivots, certain Fibonacci levels, gap levels, moving averages, those are the levels that you wanna pay attention to. So let's see how that plays out. We'll go from there. Hope you guys enjoy your weekend, and good luck trading next week.